Hi, I'm Chris Curry, creative professional and photographer. Today we're going to be taking a look at this simple looping paper background texture inside of Adobe After Effects. It's a really easy tutorial to follow along with. We're going to start inside of Photoshop first, create our texture there, and then import that to After Effects and do the rest. So let's not waste any time and jump right in. We're going to start by bringing our paper texture into Photoshop. I'm going to right click and then click Open With. With our paper layer in Photoshop, what we first need to do is stylize this. In After Effects, my text is going to be white, so I want to darken the paper texture to create enough contrast. To do this, we're going to go down to our adjustment layers and select solid color and then make this black. Then we're going to unlock our background layer and move this above the color fill we've just created. With our paper layer selected, we're going to change the blend mode to hard light. As you can see, this has darkened the paper, but not enough for the style we're going for. Let's add a curves adjustment layer and bring down the shadows and highlights to really darken this paper. I'm going to play around with this until I'm happy. This looks good to me. The last thing I want to do is add some grain to give this overlay a bit more texture. With the top layer selected, press Command, Shift and E on your keyboard to compress all the visible layers below into one layer. Then press Command, Shift and A to bring up our camera raw editor. Go down to Effects and let's add in some grain. Click this arrow to reveal more options. I'm going to put grain to 65, size to 45, and then roughness to 50. I'm happy with this, so we're going to save it as a PSD file, and once that's done, we can open After Effects. First thing we're going to do is go over to our project panel, double click, then we need to select our PSD paper texture. Make sure you select Retain Layer Sizes and Editable Layer Styles. Next, we're going to create a new composition, so I'll click this icon in our project panel. I'm going to set this to 1920 by 1080 and call this Main Comp. Let's set the duration to 15 seconds and hit OK. Drag the paper texture into the timeline. This layer exceeds the size of our composition, which is what we want. If we click into this layer composition, we can see the four layers we had in Photoshop. Select all these layers by hitting Command A and then hit Command, Shift and C to pre-compose these. Once that's done, hit Command K to change the size of our current composition to 1920 by 1080. Our paper texture is now contained within this composition on one layer, so we're now free to move it around and have enough space to work with. In our timeline, let's jump forward 10 keyframes. The shortcut to do this is Command, Shift and press the right arrow key. To go back 5 keyframes, hold Command and press the left arrow key 5 times. Split this layer using Command, Shift and D. Delete the new layer we've just created. Then using the shortcut Command D, I'm going to create duplicates of these layers. I'm going to do this 8 times. Select all these layers and right click and go to Keyframe Assistant, then Sequence Layers. If we play this now, nothing happens. That's because we need to change the position of each of these layers. So let's do this for each of the individual layers by moving them manually and making sure that there's no repetition. This is pretty straightforward, so I'm going to speed this up. With that done, here's what our preview looks like. Looking good. Moving back to our main composition, you'll see that the background texture doesn't fill the entire duration of our timeline. What we want is this layer to perpetually loop. The way I used to do this back when I was first learning After Effects was create copies of each of the layers and then just simply offset them like we've just done. While this does work, there is a really simple way to loop this texture using just one layer. First thing we need to do is right click, then go to Time and enable Time Remapping. Let's move our playhead right to the end of this layer and zoom right in. We're going to add a keyframe one frame just before the layer ends, and then we're going to delete the other keyframe at the end. Next, we need to head over to the Time Remapping stopwatch and hold Option on our keyboard and press this to open our expression controls. Once we've done this, click this small play button, go to Property and then select Loop Out. We've just added a small piece of code to our texture that tells After Effects to continually loop this layer. Make sure you extend your layer to the full width of the composition. Let's preview this and watch what happens. And there we have it, our looping paper texture. This is a really simple but versatile technique. Thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Don't forget to subscribe and have a great day.